If I'm to stay here until my research is complete, I'd better learn to hide my true nature from the mortals. But what about my thirst for blood?
Hurry now, Doctor. It's freezing here. I don't have all night. Hurry now, Doctor. It's freezing here. Dr. Swansea asked me to collect you, Dr. Reed. Hurry up! Come on, I don't have all night.
Yes, Nurse Crane? How can I help you?
I'm so sorry. I know Dr. Swansea wanted you to rest, but we have somewhat of a crisis.
A crisis, you say?
Our supply of antiseptics is nearly depleted. I was hoping there was another box up here, but...
What type of hospital are you running? No antiseptics?
You have been away too long, Doctor. With the war, and now this epidemic, supplies have been running scarce for months now.
I may have a solution. In France, during the war, drugs shortage was a daily problem, and we had to use our wits to overcome the shortages.
However do you mean?
If combined correctly, certain household chemical products can be used in a pinch instead. Now, where's the hospital storeroom?
The storeroom? Fat chance. This is the Pembroke, and space is luxury we don't have. Everything used to be stored in the old morgue.
Perhaps I should look there first. Where is this morgue?
It's the large building behind the hospital. You'll need to go in the back door because it's been sealed off for sanitary reasons. Take this key. It opens a small back entrance at the end of a narrow street.
The abandoned morgue behind the hospital. A small door at the end of a narrow street. On my way, then. Thank you, nurse. Skal voices in the garden. I should investigate. If they were to find somebody. I cannot enter. Behavior is similar to the infected William Bishop. Must be the same strain. This sickness moves faster than influenza. Balls of Mars. Fortifiers. As popular as they are ineffective. But they do contain iron tartrate, and that might prove itself useful. This key will surely grant me access to the basement. These skals feed from corpses and the husks of animals. It's locked, all right. Thank you. skals can be so ferocious. I'm not sure I can defeat them without becoming stronger. To drink blood is so tempting. Sodium hypochlorite. Dangerous to administer, but efficient in the proper dosage. Good evening, nurse.
Good evening, Doctor. I don't think we've been introduced yet. My name is Pippa Hawkins.
And I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. Dr. Swansea has recently offered me a position in this hospital.
Well, it's a euphemism that your help will be appreciated, Doctor.
Goodbye, Nurse Hawkins.
Fear and disgust on every street corner.
Good evening, Milton.
Good evening, Doctor. Still trying to save lives.
I have some good news, Milton.
What? The epidemic's over?
I retrieved your wallet. With all the money and a certain picture.
Well, yeah. Pippa Hawkins is my girl. So what? Is it the difference of skin color that bothers you?
Not at all, Milton.
Good. Please, take this money anyway. To remind you to keep your mouth shut. Not everybody's as broad-minded as you, Dr. Reed.
What's going on between you and Nurse Hawkins?
Pippa's tired. Tired of all this shit. Tired of all those corpses piling up. She's as depressed as I am.
During the war, I witnessed a few couples just like you come together in difficult circumstances. It can be very damaging.
Maybe you're right. But we support each other. And that's all that matters.
You do realize you could both get fired. Hospital staff are not meant to have intimate relationships with one another.
Come on, Dr. Reed. Do you know how many rules are broken in this hospital every day just to keep it running? There's nothing wrong with what we're doing.
Goodbye, Milton. It's locked, all right. Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reed. I believe we're going to be colleagues.
Reed, yes, I've been informed about your arrival. I'm Waverly Aykroyd. Welcome aboard, I suppose.
Does my arrival inconvenience you in some way, Dr. Aykroyd?
Let us just say that I don't particularly share Dr. Swans' enthusiasm for hiring you. What we need here are reliable professionals, not overrated dabblers.
Thank you for your time. We'll talk later.
Finally, you've returned, Doctor. Did you find anything of value?
Yes, nurse.
You've worked your first miracle, Doctor. Now, this patient here needs immediate treatment.
Duty calls? When the storm has passed, I'll show you how to mix the remedy yourself with the same basic ingredients.
Many thanks, Doctor. When you've finished, you ought to report to Dr. Swansea in his office. He's been looking for you. Seemed pressing.
Waste your time with me.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Reed. Can I help at all?
No.
Really? Why are you here, then?
I don't want to talk. My throat hurts too much.
I suppose that this pain is the reason you're here. Is someone taking care of you?
Yes. And no.
Could you at least tell me your name, sir?
Mortimer. Mortimer Goswick.
Do you need any help?
I'm afraid I may, sir. I don't mean to be a burden.
You are not a burden, sir. Healing you is my responsibility.
And you have my gratitude for that.
Do you need any help?
Thank you, Dr. Reed, but you've done enough already. The rest is up to me now.
I have to go now, sir. But don't hesitate to contact me if you need any help.
Good evening, sir. Doctor.
I will not let you
down. Good evening, madam. Can I help you?
It's my son who needs you, sir.
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. How can I help your son?
I'm Beatrice Goswick, mother of Mortimer Goswick. Could you check on him, please, Dr. Reed? I've heard much of your talents as a physician.
Goodbye, Mrs. Goswick.
As for me, what a blundering idiot.
I'm all right.
Will you ask Dr. Reed? I know that Pembroke will...